गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाइब्रिडाइजेशन इन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स, एल्केन्स एल्केन्स एल्काइन्स. टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट हाइब्रिडेशन बिफोर वी शुड लर्न सम हाइब्रिडेशन एग्जांपल्स. सो यस्टरडे 5 or 6 होमवर्क गिवन. सो द फर्स्ट वन इज अगेन व्हाट इज हाइब्रिडेशन, दैट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड नो. सो द फर्स्ट एग्जांपल PCl5. चेक योर आंसर्स राइट और रॉन्ग, अदरवाइज चेक माय आंसर्स राइट और रॉन्ग. Which is better? My answer is right or wrong? Very good. PCl5. Center element? Phosphorus. Phosphorus atomic number? 15. Configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. This is the last valence shell configuration. Okay? 3s2, 3p3. Now, in third shell, D also present or not? D. Third shell. Second shell, no D. But in third shell, D. So, here I am writing 3D0. No electron. Otherwise, where it will jump? Chance not there now. Okay? That's why I am taking here 3D0. Phosphorus bonded with 5-chlorine. Bonded with 5-chlorine means meaning 5 unpaid electrons. Yes or no? 5 unpaid electrons. How many unpaid electrons here? 3 unpaid electrons. This is pair. Now we want 5 unpaid electrons. Then what we should do? Jump. So jump, where it will jump? If this one not there. Any chance to jump? No chance. That's why now we are taking 3D0. So one electron jump. Okay. Now it is the excited state. In excited state, electron jump to empty boxes. Okay. So now here configuration, in this D one electron. Now how many unpaired electrons? 5, bonded with 5-chlorine. Now clear no? So 1s, 3p, 1d mix. Then what is the hybridization? sp3d. So the hybridization is a sp3d. How many hybrid orbitals? How many mixed? Same number. How many mixed here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 mixed, 5 orbitals formed. Now phosphorus. In this phosphorus, 5 hybrid orbitals formed. Hybrid orbital shape? 1 big, 1 small. This is a hybrid orbital. Here 1 unpaid electron. And 1 big, 1 small. Here also 1 unpaid electron. 1 big, 1 small. Unpaid electron. Small. Unpaired electron. Like this, 5 hybrid orbitals arranged. So total 5 orbitals with unpaid electrons. All these unpaired electrons only. Okay. Now in this phosphorus, 5 hybrid orbitals with 5 unpaired electrons. Each chlorine, 1 unpaired electron. Where this unpaired electron? S or P? S or P? P. In P orbital, 1 unpaired electron. This chlorine donating 1 unpaired electron, this unpaired electron bonded with each other. Like that, total 5 chlorine atoms. So the molecule is a PCl5. Like this, bond formation takes place. So finally, structure of PCl5 is like this. Okay? This structure name trigonal bipyramidal. Structure name. Trigonal bipyramidal. Anyhow, this is the structure. What is this bond? Sigma bond. Which type of sigma bond? Sigma sp3d of phosphorus and p orbital of chlorine. So, which type of sigma bonds are formed? Sigma sp3d p bonds. Like that, total 5 bonds are present. So, this is the structure of a PCl5. So, in PCl5, what is the hybridization? sp3d. Your answer, my answer. Matched or not? Half of her. Okay. So, hybridization sp3d. Okay. So, come to the next one. Second one, SF6. SF6. Sulfur. Atomic number? 16. configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. Ground state 3s2, 3p4. Okay. Now, bonded with how many fluorine? 6. 6 unpaired electrons we want. 6 unpaired electrons are there? Not there. Then what we should do? Jump. Where it should jump? What is the D? K, empty here? D. So now we are taking 3D0. Okay? No electrons. 3D empty. Okay? This is the ground state. Now first excited state. One electron jump. From this pair. Here to here come. Okay? One electron jump. Now how many unpaired electrons? Unpaired electrons. Okay. So for new students, today, yesterday, joint students, definitely it is difficult to understand. So to understand this, from beginning all videos once you watch. Okay. Otherwise, what happening here? Something boxes are there. These are electrons. So how these are electrons? How these are jump here? Okay. Many doubts, many question marks. Complete brain question marks only. Okay. Otherwise, leave. No problem. Once again, we are going to discuss. Everything, once again, we will explain. That's why no need to worry. How much you can understand? Try to understand that much. Okay? Now, electron gem. How many unpaired electrons? 4 unpaired electrons. But how many we want? 6. Now, what to do? Jump one more time. Jump. How many pairs are there? All those based on our requirement. Now, 6 unpaired electrons, 1s, 3p, 2d, total mix. Now, what is the hybridization? sp3d2, okay? Like this structure not required, just a sulfur. How many unpaired electrons now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay? So, sp3d2, sp3d2, all these are sp3d2 electrons, okay? Now, for pairing these bonded with fluorine. Fluorine atomic number? 9. Configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. 2p5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is unpaired electron. How many unpaired electrons? 1. Where? P orbital. This is P orbital, no. So in P orbital, 1 unpaired electron. Sharing. Like this total, 6 fluorine atoms bonded with this. Like this sharing takes place, 6 bonds are formed. Okay. This structure name octahedral. Structure name octahedral. sp3d2 hybridization and structure is the octahedral. So what is the nature of this bond now? Sigma sp3d2 p. P orbital of fluorine, sp3d2 orbital of sulfur. All bonds are identical bonds. Anyhow, here hybridization is a sp3d2. Okay. Next example. Clear now? This is also same answer. All correct. Next. Third example, H2O. Right? H2O. Here which one is the center? O. Oxygen. Atomic number 8. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. 2s2, 2p4. Now, bonded with 2 hydrogens. Nothing but how many unpaired electrons we want? 2. 2 unpaired electrons there are not. There. No need to jump. Okay. Now, what is the hybridization? P2. P2 like hybridization there? No. We should mix with S or not? Yes, this one we want. Up to this. Mix all. So what is the hybridization here? sp3. Only sp2 we can't take. This one also we want. Okay, sp3 hybridization. How many hybrid orbitals? 4. In 2 orbitals like this space. Okay, 2 orbital space. I will write like this. In remaining 2 orbitals, unpaired. Now this one bonded with a hydrogen. Hydrogen unpaired electron in which orbital? Hydrogen unpaired electron in which orbital? Yes, because hydrogen atomic number 1, configuration 1s1, bonded. And one more hydrogen bonded. Here two lone pairs, that's, these are called lone pairs, not involving bonding. Now these are bond pairs. Okay, so oxygen, two lone pairs, two bond pairs. So the shape is a V shape. V shape or angular. Okay, so what is this bond now? Sigma sp3 s. So the bond is sigma sp3 s. Okay. Next example, NCl3. NCl3. First tell me your answer. Till now 3 examples, my answers you check now. Now I will check your answers. Tell me. 3 bonds, sigma. Okay, hybridization sp3. That is your answer. Second example, one next example. PCl3. Sigma sp3p. So here also sp3 hybridization. Next example. IF7. IF7 answer. Sigma sp3d3. So here sp3d3 hybridization. 3 right or wrong? Start this first one. NCl3, nitrogen atomic number 7. 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Okay, 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. 2s2, 2p3. How many unpaired electrons? 3 unpaired electrons. Bonded with 3 chlorine. So 3 unpaired electrons. Again you should jump? No, not required. At least to jump, any chance? 2D? 2D is there. Any vacant here? No vacant. No chance to jump. That's why just NCl3 only. NCl5 like that, chance not there. Now 1s, 3p. Hybridization sp3. So 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. 1. Pair, remaining 3 unpaired. Okay, now this one bonded with Cl. Chlorine which orbital? P orbital. So what is this bond? Sigma sp3p. Like that, 3 bonds. So hybridization sp3 hybridization. Second one, PCl3. Phosphorus 15. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. 3s2, 3p3. 3s2, 3p3. Bonded with 3 chlorine. So how many unpaired electrons? 3. We want 3 only. As it is there, no? So no jump. Any chance to jump? If want? 3D is there. 3D. No D in 3. 3D is there. So this can jump, but not jump. Why not jump? Here bonded with only 3 chlorine. 3 unpaired electrons only we want. If it is PCl5, 5 we want. That time jump. Okay. But here NCl5 will jump. NCl5. NCl5 means here if D is there, it can jump, no. But any D? No D. That's why no NCl5. Like this molecule only not there. Okay? But PCl5 there. So here jump, here not required, this much enough. Now 1s3p, sp3. Okay. So phosphorus, one paired, three unpaired, bonded with 3-chlorine. So the nature of the bond is sigma, sp3p. sp3 of this, p of this one. So this is also correct. Come to that IF7. Iodine atomic number 53. Configuration. One is two. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. Right or wrong? First tell me that. 53 right. Iodine. 4s2, 3d10, 4p6, 5s2, 5d, 4d10, 5p5. So what is that last term? 5s2, 5p5. That is the last term. Yes or no? Last configuration, 5s2, 5p5. This is 53. Right or wrong? How to prove? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Okay. Fluorine, 9. 9 plus 8. 17. 17 plus? 17 plus? How much we should take? 18? No. 17 plus 18. How much? 17 plus 18. 35. Plus 18. Plus 18. 53. So what is the atomic number? 53. Plus 8 plus 18 plus 18. Okay. So iodine atomic number 53, configuration 5s2, 5p3. So that's the last 5s2, 5p5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now IF7 bonded with how many fluorine? 7. How many unpaired electrons we want? 7. How many there? 1. What we should do? Jump, jump, jump. How many times? So jump which one? Where we should jump? Where? 5s, 5p, 5d is present or not? In fifth shell D, 5d, 5d empty. Same shell, after 5p, 6s will come, that's why jump to 6s don't take. Next shell it will not jump, same shell, okay? That's why 5d. Now jump this. 3 unpaired electrons, we want 7. Again jump. 5 unpaired electrons, we want 7. Again jump. 7 unpaired electrons. Okay. Now 1s, 3p, 3d. Mix. What is the hybridization? sp3, d3. Okay. Total how many unpaired electrons? 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Bonded with 7 fluorine. Like this iodine bonded with 7 fluorine. So what is this, the nature of this bond? Like this 7 fluorines bonded. What is this bond? Sigma sp3 d3 fluorine p. So all these bonds are sigma sp3 d3 p bonds. Okay. Next example. Our homework. This much only given. Okay. 3 yours, 3. From my side. Total 6 correct. Now come to alkenes, alkenes, alkynes. How to identify hybridization here? Alkenes. Actually till now what we learned that not required. But to identify this hybridization we should learn. Okay. So alkanes. Alkanes means single bonds are present. Between two carbons, only single bonds are present. So how these bonds are formed? What is that hybridization? Okay. For example, alkane. You take CH4 only. Why again CH4? One more. Which one? C2H6. Ethane. Take this C2H6. Center element carbon. Center element carbon. Okay. This carbon atomic number 6. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. 2s2, 2p2. This is ground state. Carbon always compounds in excited state. Excited state, nothing but jump. Okay. Now, what is the hybridization? How to identify the hybridization? First, see this. Between carbons, only single bonds are present. Single bond means that is a sigma bond. So here alkanes, all sigma bonds only present, only single bonds are present. That is the ethane, propane, butane, pentane, anyone given. Between carbons, only single bonds. Only single bonds means only sigma bonds. Hybrid orbitals only can form sigma bonds. Pi bond anyone is there, that is the unhybrid orbital. Pi bonds only from unhybrid orbitals. One sigma, one pi. This is from hybrid, but this one from unhybrid. So pi bond is there, that is from unhybrid orbital. Single bonds are there, they are sigma bonds. All sigma bonds from hybrid orbitals only. Now here any pi bond? No pi bond. No pi bond means no unhybrid. Total involved in hybridization. Unhybrid not required. So total involved in hybridization. Nothing but this complete hybridization. So what is that hybridization? sp3. So direct alkane given, always the hybridization is a sp3 hybridization. So in alkanes, carbon always undergoes sp3 hybridization. Because here only single bonds are present. Like this single bonds are present means they are sigma bonds. Sigma bonds getting from hybrid. Pi bonds only from unhybrid. No pi bond. Unhybrid we don't want. So total involved in hybridization. That's why the hybridization is a sp3. Now carbon. sp3 hybridization. How many hybrid orbitals? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 4 hybrid orbitals, 4 unpaired electrons. Like this. Another carbon also 4 hybrid orbitals, 4 unpaired electrons. Same. Carbon sp3 hybridization. So sp3 hybrid orbital of this carbon, sp3 of this carbon, here bonding. Sharing takes place. Like this here, sp3 of this carbon, s orbital of hydrogen bonded. sp3 of this one, s of hydrogen, s orbital of hydrogen, s orbital of hydrogen, s orbital of hydrogen. Like this bonded. Now it is a C2H6. So what is this bond? Sigma. Which type of sigma? Sigma. This is which orbital? sp3 orbital of this carbon. This is which orbital? sp3 orbital of that carbon. sp3 of this mixed. Nothing but what is this one? sp3, sp3. So between two carbons, which bond is present in alkanes? Given the answer is a sigma sp3, sp3 bond is present. What is this bond? Sigma sp3 of carbon, but s of a hydrogen. I think but this is a sigma sp3, yes. Like that, how many sigma sp3 s bonds? 6 sigma sp3 s bonds. How many sigma sp3, sp3 bonds? 1. 1 sigma sp3 bond and 6 sigma sp3 s bonds. Like this, alkanes given, always the hybridization is a sp3. Alkanes given, sp3 hybridization takes place. Between two carbons, which type of bond present means fixed, that is a sigma sp3 bond is present. Like this, it forms a single bond. Double bond, how it will form? Double bond means that is a alkene. Tell me any one example for alkene. C2H4. Small one best. C2H4. Between two carbons, double bond. Okay. How many pi bonds here? One pi bond. One pi bond. To form one pi bond, definitely one unhybrid. We want one unhybrid. One unhybrid means one we should leave, that not involving hybridization, because this must form a pi bond. Alkenes means pi bond is present between two carbons, double bond. One is sigma, one is pi. Like this we will represent. One is sigma, one is pi. Pi from unhybrid. One pi formed means definitely in this carbon one unhybrid is there. One we should leave, that not involving hybridization. Remaining involving hybridization. Remaining means what is the hybridization? Sp2. Four are there. Why four not involved? Why not sp3? Why not sp3? Because one unhybrid we want. Why we should need that unhybrid? Because here one pi bond is there. One pi bond is there. One unhybrid. That's why one not involving hybridization. Remaining only involving hybridization. So the hybridization is the sp2. Again, now it is fixed. Alkene given, the hybridization is a sp2 only. Double bonded carbon hybridization is always a sp2. Sp2 means how many hybrid? Three. Three hybrid. Now see this one. Three hybrid. One, two, three. Here also three hybrid. One, two, three. Okay. Sp2 hybrid of this carbon, sp2 hybrid of that carbon bonded. So what is this bond? Sigma sp2 sp2. Yes or no? Here sp2 hybridization, there also sp2 hybridization. So what is this bond? Sigma sp2 sp2 bond. Now sp2 of carbon, s of hydrogen. Sp2 of carbon, s orbital of hydrogen. Carbon, hydrogen, carbon, hydrogen. Now what is this bond? Sigma sp2. Yes, like that. How many? Four. Four sigma sp2. Yes. And this one, what about this? Not involving hybridization. This is unhybrid. One electron in p orbital. Like this, in this carbon also one electron in p orbital. These two combined forms pi bond. Pi bond only from unhybrid. For that hybridization not required. So these two forms pi bond. Which type of pi now it is? A unpaired electron of this, unpaired electron of another carbon. Which type of pi? P pi, P pi, P pi, D pi. Pi PP, pi PD. Which type of pi bond? Nothing but which orbital involved? What is this orbital? P orbital. P orbital of this carbon, P orbital of this carbon. Yes or no? So which type of pi bond? PP pi bond. So what are the bonds present in ethene given? The correct answer is a 1 sigma sp2 sp2 bond and 4 sigma sp2 s bonds and 1 pi PP bond. 1 pi PP bond is present. So alkenes given, always the hybridization is a sp2 hybridization. Okay. Now come to alkyne. Alkyne means between two carbons, triple bond is present. Triple bond present, alkyne, double bond, alkene, single bond, alkane. Single bond means no unhybrid, sp3 hybridization. Double bond means one we are leaving, sp2 hybridization. Now, for this example, C2H2, ethyne. Okay. Now, triple bond. Two pi bonds. Triple bond means two pi bonds, no. One sigma, two pi. Two pi bonds means unhybrid only can form pi bond. So how many we have to leave? Two. Leave two. These two not in hybridization. What is the hybridization? Sp. So here always the hybridization is a sp. Alkynes, triple bonded carbon hybridization is always sp. Why sp? We are leaving two. Why we are leaving two? Two pi bonds. So for the formation of two pi bonds, two orbitals not mixed. Remaining only mixed. That's why the hybridization is a sp. So one carbon, sp, sp. Like this, another carbon, sp, sp. Sp of this, sp of this. One sigma, sp, sp. Okay. Sp of this, s of hydrogen. sigma sp s sp of this s of hydrogen sigma sp s okay remaining two unhybrid in this carbon also unhybrid these two one pi bond these two one pi bond which type of bond pi p p here p orbital there also p orbital so two pi p p bonds are present okay so now final conclusion now what we want this much we don't want alkanes given if carbon forms single bonds like this the hybridization is a sp3 okay carbon forms double bond like this the hybridization is a sp2 if carbon form that triple bond nothing but two pi bonds if it form two pi bonds the hybridization is a sp so based on this hybridization carbon can form single bond double bond triple bond single bond means sigma bonds double bond one sigma one pi bond triple bond one sigma two pi bonds based on that hybridization so alkanes sp3 hybridization alkenes sp2 hybridization and alkynes of sp hybridization okay single bond sp3 double bond sp2 triple bond sp now based on this how they will ask questions leave the remaining total part now in your mind just fix a single bond sp3 double bond sp2 triple bond sp till now what we discussed leave this delete now freshly fix what you should fix alkene single bond sp3 double bond alkenes sp2 triple bond alkynes sp hybridization okay now see this carbon valency 4 okay ch3 ch2 ch2 ch double bond ch c triple bond c ch3 like this given one carbon compound organic compounds many organic compounds are there no this is one organic compound ch3 ch2 ch2 ch double bond ch single bond c triple bond c single bond ch3 like this one compound given the number of carbons with sp3 sp2 sp hybridization this is the question the number of carbons with sp3 sp2 sp hybridization director okay finished tell me 5 sp3 1 sp2 1 sp3 sp any other answers question listen that question no watch that question the number of carbon with sp3 sp2 sp hybridization single bond sp3 double bond sp2 triple bond sp this one point only we fixed here shall I explain one example then remaining examples you can identify and now see this around this carbon check single bonds are present any double bond present around this carbon here single bond bonded with hydrogen means definitely in 10th standard you learn like this H okay like this only learn no that time you are small kids so like this H separated now like that not required just CH3 nothing but this bonded with three hydrogen this one how H okay this one H this is like H here it is a H and here no H here H carbon, four bonds, nothing but what a given structure, correct structure only. Okay, now around this carbon are single bonds, nothing but what is the hybridization of this carbon? sp3. So this carbon sp3. Okay, around this carbon are single bonds only there, nothing but what is the hybridization? All sigma bonds, sp3. Around this carbon all single bonds only there, what is the hybridization? sp3. Around this carbon one side double bond there, this one involving double bond formation, one we are leaving, then hybridization sp2. This one around this double bond involving for the bond formation two atoms should involve, so this also sp2. Okay, around this triple bond, this involving 3 2 pi bonds, sp. This involving triple bond formation, 2 pi bonds, sp. Around this single bonds only there, sp3. Now answer the number of carbons with sp3. 1 2 3 4. Four carbons with sp3. Number of carbons with sp2. Two carbons with sp2. Number of carbons with sp, 2 carbons with sp. If the question is what is the ratio, 4:2:2, ratio 2:1:1, no, answer is 2:1:1 ratio. Just carbons given 4, 2, 2. Okay, so the number of carbons with sp3, sp2, sp 4, 2, 2. What is the ratio given? Answer 2:1:1. Shall I give example now? Start. Number of carbons with sp3, sp2, sp. CH3, that is 3. This is 2. Answer sp3 3, sp2 4, sp 4 3 3 4. Just see how many carbons, 1 2 3, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Next number 11. Total 11 carbons, sir? Yes or no? 11 carbons, sir. 4, 3, 3. 11, huh? 10. 4, 4, 3. 11. Total 11 carbons are there. Then what is the answer? 3, 4, 4. Check this, sir. Around this. Again, HH, no need to write, no. H, there means single bond. Around this single, SP3. Around this double pi bond, one pi bond, SP2. Around this one pi bond, SP2. Around this no pi bond, SP3. Around this one pi bond, SP2. Around this one pi bond, SP2. Around this two pi bonds, SP. Two pi bonds, SP. Two pi bonds, SP. Around this two pi bonds, SP. Around this no pi bond, SP3. Okay? So, 1, 2, 3. 3 SP3. 2 to 4 SP2. 2 to 4 SP. Okay? Now, what is the ratio? Again, simple chance not there. 3 is to 4 is to 4. This is the ratio of SP3, SP2, SP. Now, same question. The ratio of sigma and pi bonds. Tell me. The ratio of sigma and pi bonds. One explain, then remaining you can identify. Will you try? Try that. Ratio of sigma and pi bonds. What you will give the answer? Ratio of sigma and pi bonds. Otherwise, just the number of sigma, number of pi. Total number of sigma, total number of pi bonds. Tell me, share it, no punishment. 6 pi, okay, that is clear. Sigma, 10 sigma. Any other answer? Ten sigma, six pi. Fix. Fix. Shall I log this? Right or wrong, check it. This is sigma or pi? Sigma. Here, one sigma, one pi. One sigma. 1 sigma, 1 sigma, 1 pi, 1 sigma, 1 sigma, 2 pi, 1 sigma, 1 sigma, 2 pi, 1 sigma, okay. How many sigma bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10, okay. Pi bonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 pi. And CH3, like this, no? What is this bond? Sigma or pi? Sigma or pi? Neither sigma nor pi. Sigma, how many sigma bonds? 3, 3 sigma bonds. This one? 4 sigma bonds. This one? 5 sigma bonds. 6, 7 sigma bonds, 8 sigma bonds, 9 sigma bonds. All these hydrogen sigma bonds only, no? 10, 11, 12 sigma words. Here 10, here 12. Total 22 sigma words. 22 sigma words. Then wrong answer. Okay. So total number of sigma bonds 22 and pi bonds 6. Okay. And now same question. The number of sp3, sp2, sp hybrid orbitals. The question is, what is the previous question? The number of carbons with sp3 hybridization, 3 carbons sp3. The number of carbons with sp2 hybridization, 4 carbons. The number of carbons with sp hybridization, 4. Now question is the total hybrid. The number of sp3 hybrid orbitals, sp2 hybrid orbitals, sp hybrid orbitals. How many? Number of sp3 hybrid orbitals. Shall I explain this example? One better know. See this. Question is, how many sp3, sp2, sp hybrid orbitals are present? Like that given, sp3, 1s, 3p mixed. How many mixed same number of hybrid orbitals produced? 4 mixed means how many hybrid? 4. 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals we are getting. Hybridization sp3 means 4 hybrid orbitals, 1s plus 3p. 4 hybrid orbitals. sp2 hybridization means 3 hybrid orbitals, 1 is unhybrid. Okay. sp2 hybridization, 1s, 2p mixed. How many mixed same number will produce? Same number of hybrid orbitals. How many hybrid orbitals? 3. 3 hybrid means 1 is unhybrid because involved in pi bonding. 1 unhybrid. Here how many unhybrid? 0. Any pi bond? No. No unhybrid. 4 hybrid. 3 hybrid. 3 hybrid. sp3 hybridization. 4 hybrid. Any unhybrid? Any pi bond? No. No unhybrid. Here. Now very simple. sp2. 3 hybrid. 1 unhybrid. sp2. 3 hybrid, 1 unhybrid. sp2 hybrid, remaining 1 because involved in 2 pi bonds. 2 unhybrid, 2 hybrid, 2 unhybrid, 2 hybrid, 2 unhybrid, 2 hybrid, 2 unhybrid, 4 hybrid, no unhybrid. Okay. Now, how many sp3 hybrid orbitals? 4. The sp3 hybrid orbitals, how many? 3. 4 plus 4 plus 4, how many? 3 carbons, but how many orbitals? 12 sp3 hybrid orbitals. How many sp2 hybrid orbitals? 3 plus 3 3 3. How many? 12 sp2 hybrid orbitals. How many sp hybrid orbitals? Here sp, 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, 8 sp hybrid orbitals. If the question is ratio, sp3, sp2, sp hybrid orbitals ratio. Then answer, 12, 12, 8. Ratio, 12 is to 12 is to 8. Okay, 4 threes are 4 twos. Okay, so what is the ratio? 3 is to 3 is to 2. It is the identification of a number of sp3, sp2. So why we should learn in this chapter hybridization? To identify this. Okay, single bond sp3, double bond sp2, and triple bond sp hybridization. So continuation, same concept. Continuation tomorrow. Okay, thank you.